Hi, I'm Satoshi Nakahira from JAXA. So I'm glad to hear. Thank you very much for inviting me. So I'm going to talk on Grafana use case in space in Japanese moon lander stream on behalf of these guys. So this is the agenda of today's talk. And I'm going to talk on about me, about my institution, and overview of three mission, and then we talk on implementation of stream and our requirement for quick look system and system overview and example of dashboard we have created. So first about me, I'm working on science satellite operation unit and data archive unit of ISAS JAXA. And my folk, I was originally majoring in astrophysics for 10 years. But then my focus is moving to engineering science. I'm involved in open data archive of space science observational data. This is my site, DARTS, named DARTS. And I also involved in operational systems of space science probes or satellites. So then moved to my institution, and JAXA is space agency of Japan, and ISAS is division of JAXA on space science. And as you can see this photo, we have operating many various type of satellite or probes. And so let's take a look. This is solar image by Hinode Solar Telescope. And this is Akatsuki Moon Orbiter image. And then this movie is from Kaguya Moon Orbiter. And this is asteroid named Ryugu by Hayabusa 2 probe. And smaller image is microscopic image of samples that Hayabusa 2 brought back to Earth. And this energy spectrum is taken by CRISM, launched with the same vehicle with SLIM. So you can see the mission list from here. And then I introduce the mission of SLIM. SLIM is dedicated to demonstrate high precision moon landing technology. And its goal is to achieve a pinpoint landing with 100 meters accuracy. And it will be achieved through image matching navigation and autonomous navigation guidance control. And this figure shows that SLIM observes Moon's crater and matched it with preloaded image. And this process is repeated, and then leads to the landing point. Landing point is that is named crater Shiori. And another feature of SLIM is its lightweight. So weight of SLIM body is only 200 kilograms and with 500 kilograms of propellant. So let's move to actual data of SLIM. In this figure, center is the Earth, and the white circle is Moon orbit. And yellow line is actual trajectory of SLIM. So SLIM launched on September 7, and this is a movie of launch. So SLIM stays around Earth for a while, and then left Earth and set off to the Moon at October 1st. So then, SLIM executed Moon swing by on October 4, and then reached to its farthest point of three times as far as Moon, and then go back to Moon on Christmas of last year. And this movie is taken at that time, so crater is very clear, so because it is approached. And then SLIM remained moon orbit for 1 month, then attempt its moon landing. So as you may know, SWIM's moon landing was successful. So I'll share you a highlight of SWIM, highlight of SWIM. So just before landing, SWIM released two robots named Rev1 and Rev2. And soft landing was successful. It's the first in Japan. And then pinpoint landing within 100 meter accuracy was also successful. It is, was first in the world. And then, as seen this photo, selfie is taken by robot Rev2. And unexpectedly, SWIM survived to extreme temperature shift from night to day. Among these temperature, SWIM woke up 2 times at this date. So then move to how Grafana is used in SWIM operations. So we are still using these quick look systems, and there are some problems. So as seen in the photo, there are many characters. So we are not easy to find certain parameters from here. And this software is built as a monolithic software, so it is not easy to maintain or adding new features. So then, how is the telemetry of space scientific probes is like? So we have 2 types of data. One is housekeeping data, the other is scientific data. So scientific data has include image, event by event data, spectra, but usually analyzed in more longer time scale, so not time critical. So we do not include this in real-time monitor purpose. On the other hand, housekeeping data is used to monitor the health and functionality status. So it includes voltage, current, temperature, attitude, position, velocity, acceleration, status flag counts. So it's a basic metrics. So similar to what you find in IoT devices. So any other difference between IoT and the probe data? So IoT data, we collect a small amount of telemetry from many devices. In probes, we collect a large number of telemetry from one big device. So there are, but content of data is still similar. So as a result, inspired by IoTs, we have integrated Grafana to space probes operation for enhanced observability. This is system configuration that we have integrated Grafana. Our control center receives SWIM data through ground antenna station. So we adapt InfluxDB as a data source for Grafana. And we also use API to data calculation or image generation. And in front of InfluxDB, we build data receive or register module. It is written by Python. So for data register, we of course use the InfluxDB client. And for data receive, we use the C libraries for communication protocol handling or binary decoder. It is wrapped with Python. So in this project, red text is newly written. Other is open source or released software. So we have successfully built this system with very low effort. And we also configured in a loosely coupled architecture based on REST API. And then this movie is inside of the control room just a moment before moon landing. So there are many displays. Grafana-based system is used here. And here. And this screen is streamed in real time on YouTube. So in this critical phase, control room and YouTube audience were all looking at the same Grafana dashboard at the same time. So then I show you the example of stream dashboard. We have built over 10 dashboards and constructed for each subsystem, like thermal, power, navigation, and for each phase, launch, landing, or cruise. And classical, as you see previous movie, classical quick look was still dominant, but Grafana-based system was played an important role in our operation. So this is dashboard for navigation system during cruise phase. We can easily build this system by connecting InfluxDB with Grafana. And this area, we monitor system status. And in this area, we monitor error or warning status. And in this area, we monitor log messages that generated by ground processing. We use the stat or log panel here. And rest right area, we monitor using XY plot or time series graph. We monitor attitude or attitude change or solar angle. And next dashboard is for heater status. Heater is important because instrument can be damaged by extremely low temperature on the space. So this dashboard is scrollable and several pages of information below. In this area, we monitor power-related metrics. For example, power generation, power usage. And this second graph provides a clear view for total power consumption is with share for each component is stacked graph. So Slim has about 50 heaters. And so it is controlled autonomously, but it is important to monitor its duty cycle. It was easy with this state timeline panel. So we can compare it with temperature from shown in left side. So this dashboard is for thrusters and maneuver monitor. And used in attitude change or orbit change. So SIM has two main big thrusters and 12 smaller thrusters. So it is arranged to reflect its physical layout. So with this layout, we can easily check the status. And with this gauge, we saw the remaining fuel of stream thruster. And we also check remaining battery here. And this 3D is used to monitor its attitude in relation of sun and earth. And it is implemented by Python API. And image is generated by offline rendering by using TreeMesh or PyRender libraries. And generated image is passed to Grafana with Base64 format. So the dashboard that use variable future of Grafana worked very efficiently for us. This movie shows demo. So So we set string current CUR of current and check parameter, and the parameter is shown. So change parameter and query variables. So how it is set up? We use the two variables. One is text box. The other is query. So we used text box as filtering strings. And the second query variable, we wrote this command of InfluxDB. And as a result, we obtain list of filtered telemetry names. So this is list of telemetry name, and if we check here, we can show the multiple graphs with repeat option of Grafana. So then finally, I'll show you a recorded movie during the moon landing. This dashboard is almost the same of the previous one, but this figure is new. So horizontal axis is distance, and vertical axis is altitude. And white line is actual planned trajectory of stream, and red one is actual trajectory over last 5 minutes. So then start. Now it's free fall phase. And then thruster is firing in full power. You can see fuel is decreasing rapidly. And then vertical velocity is almost neutralized. And start vertical descending. So this is the final phase. Seems to be just above landing point at altitude of 6 kilometers. Then it starts going down. 3 kilometers. And 1 kilometer, hovering at 500 meters. And then hovering again. So arrive to moon. And this number shows the recent time stamp of stream. So this is moving. So if when we see this is changing, we believe the stream is alive and the moon soft landing was successful. So let me conclude with our impression to Grafana. So we were able to build the entire system quite easily. And the visualization capability was broad, from simple one to detailed graphs. We are also able to create dashboards that were well received and visually impressive. And for me, editing was straightforward and could be done even during operations. The variable future was a game changer for us and extremely convenient. So, and being able to calling Python from the API is that mean we could do everything. So, as summarized, we are glad to use Grafana. Yeah, once more, thank you very much for Grafana community. Let's go to the next planet with JAXA. Thank you.